Assalamu alaikum. Welcome everybody from Sunway Admission. Today we are live with Ms. Rachel. She's from Western Indian University from US, and she's the international head for Western New England University. So today we will be discussing about to study in this university. Especially we want to know about the courses, the tuition fees, and the facilities the university is offering. So let's start the discussion with Ms. Rachel. So Ms. Rachel, welcome to our live session today.
Hi, thank you so much for having me. It's a pleasure to be here.
Yeah, thank you. So I just want to know, like, you know, every student wants to know about the US universities. So today we are talking about Western New England University. So just tell us something about the university.
Sure. So Western New England University is based in Springfield, Massachusetts, which is about an hour and a half away from Boston and about 2.5 hours away from New York City. So it's a really excellent geographic location because students can easily get into those really large cities for lots of activities, to do some of those tourist activities. But then our campus is really residential and suburban. So it's a really great geographic location. We have about 4,000 students total, so we're a mid-size institution, and our campus is very international student friendly. We guarantee on-campus housing for all students, and we have a lot of different options in terms of academic programs, so students can choose between 5 colleges: our arts and sciences, business, engineering, pharmacy and health studies, and our school of law. So a lot of different options and a lot of ways for students to get involved.
Oh, wow. Sounds good. So If you just tell us shortly about the programs like bachelor, graduate, and PhD academic programs.
Sure. So we have over 90 academic programs. This includes bachelor's, master's, and PhD programs. I mentioned our 5 different colleges. So the majority of students for the graduate programs will enroll in our engineering programs. We were just ranked within the top 100 engineering programs in the US, which we're really excited about. So at the undergraduate level, again, students can choose from business, arts and sciences, engineering, pharmacy and health sciences, and our school of law. So we offer both majors and minors, meaning a student could major in, for example, business and minor in sports management, or maybe they want to major in biology and minor in health sciences. So a lot of different options there. And then at the graduate level, as I mentioned, our engineering programs are definitely the strongest. And we have currently 5 PhD programs in both engineering and applied behavioral analysis, which is more closely related to psychology and education.
Okay. So if any students wants to start their study at Western New England University, then what will be the, you know, initial steps they can start?
Sure. So everything is done right online. We don't require any sort of paper application or paper transcripts. So the students first fill out an online application. For the undergraduate programs, all we really require is a copy of their high school transcripts. And we don't need a credential evaluation. The students will simply send us in their transcripts. We'll do a full evaluation for them. And then we'll offer an admissions decision based on their high school grades. We are test optional, which means we don't require the SAT or the ACT score, which I know is a barrier for a lot of international students. And then the final piece that we'll need is proof of English proficiency. So our IELTS minimum score is a 6.0 for undergraduate students, and our TOEFL minimum score is a 79. And then we also accept Duolingo as a new, really popular option because students can use their phones and they can take the test completely from home. So again, the online application, transcripts, and then proof of English proficiency, and that's all we need for undergraduate programs. For graduate, there are a few other requirements. We look for a copy of the student's resume, 2 recommendation letters, and we don't require the GRE or the GMAT for our engineering programs, which I think is another barrier. So that helps speed up the application process for students.
Yeah, sounds great. So now tell us something about the tuition fees and the accommodation cost.
Sure. So undergraduate programs will range based on the academic discipline. What I mean by that is arts and sciences and business programs are around $36,000 per year for tuition. Engineering is slightly higher just due to the nature of the classes and the labs, and that's about $38,000 per year. So for undergraduate students, again, it ranges from $36,000 to $38,000, although all of our undergraduate students will receive a merit scholarship, which ranges from $10,000 to $22,000. So I always want to tell students that right up front, you know, even if tuition is close to $40,000, the merit scholarship substantially lowers that tuition fee for the students, especially if they receive the highest amount. And then for graduate students, the tuition is significantly lower. Of course, it's a shorter program. So typically the programs range from a year and a half to 2 years. And that entire program is around $35,000 for engineering, all the way as low as about $12,000 for some of the arts and sciences programs. So it ranges.
Okay, sounds great. So if any scholarship have for graduate program?
Yeah, great question. So we don't have any specific scholarships for graduate programs, but we do have fellowships and assistantships. So the fellowships are for the PhD programs, and those are fully funded fellowships. They are highly competitive and very selective, although we have a few fellows every year. And the fellows are expected to conduct research on campus, work with the faculty members, and then in turn, they receive full funding for their program. The Applied Behavioral Analysis program also has a graduate assistantship option, and so students will teach while they're also enrolled in classes. So there's a few options there. And I also wanted to mention scholarships for the undergraduate students. So alongside the merit scholarship, we have an international student-specific scholarship, and this ranges from $3,000 to $10,000 per year. And all the students need to do once they're admitted is they fill out a quick scholarship application, and they'll tell us why they want to be considered for this scholarship. And typically, then when the students arrive on campus, they like to share their experience as an international student. They like to get involved on campus, and so again, that ranges from $3,000 to $10,000, and can be combined with the merit scholarship.
Yeah. Okay. Sounds great. So now tell us something like our upcoming intake details.
Sure. So any student interested in undergraduate programs, the next intake is fall, which starts in September. We usually have the two intakes for undergraduate, either the fall and then the spring, so September or January. And then for graduate programs, we have a lot more flexibility. We have 4 entry terms per year. So the next entry term for graduate is April. That's considered our spring term. If students don't want to enroll in April, the next one after that is July, and then the next one after that is September. So the 4 for graduate are January, April, July, and September.
Okay, sounds good. I thank you, Rachel, because you tried to explain all the details, and I know you are so busy. So thank you for your time, and thank you everybody who are watching this session now. And we are officially representative for Western New England University. So if you want to know anything about this university, about the admission and, about the requirements and anything, so you just contact with us. So we will try to help you. And so thank you, Rachel, and have a good day.
Thank you so much. You take care.